Hello everyone, this is Late TT Party with my first impressions of DJ Max Respect, and holy fucking shit was I blown away by this game. Not all positive. You can be blown away by good elements, but also by bad elements of a game. But you know what, in a game like this, it probably just does come down to skill level. If it was a platformer or racing game, probably wouldn't say that. Probably would have more things to pick out of those games as negative points. In this, it just is that fucking hell, this game is tough. You might be thinking like me. You might be thinking, I own DJ Hero. I own Guitar Hero. I've played rhythm games before. This is my thing. I enjoy waiting for the little icon to come down to the lane where I hit the corresponding button. Everything's great. No. Not with DJ Max Respect. Sure, that's what you do, but it's just not like those other games. Those other games are a piece of piss compared to this. Look at what's happening on the screen right now. This is my gameplay footage. This is an easy track set at an easy level. You can see that. No surprise here. But later in this video, you will see the difficulty settings that you can go through on this game. You can increase the speed, you can select a more difficult track, and it becomes ridiculous. At least for my westernized fingers it does, because with those other games that I mentioned, the DJ Heroes, the Guitar Heroes, you've got that controller, you know, you've got the guitar, you've got the little DJ turntable. With this, look at that button configuration. Left on the D-pad, up, triangle, circle. And that's the easiest setting. I mean, that's not going to be great for anyone. But yes, you play with those four buttons long enough, you'll do alright, you'll do pretty good. You'll be like, you know, regular Guitar Hero sort of status. It's all good again. But once you even move up the tracks, once you even go to more difficult track listing, that all goes out the window. I don't find the controller scheme here to be too intuitive. But again, I understand that that might just be for me. I might be shit at the game, that's fine. But I can still appreciate it. You know, just because I'm not particularly good at a game, doesn't mean I'm going to shit all over it. People will be great at this game, and from the unintuitive button combinations, for me anyway, the first thing that sprung to mind was, yeah, this is a Japanese rhythm game. For the first time in my life, I visited Japan in 2017. Needless to say, being someone that enjoys games, went into an arcade. First time in my life, never even thought of Googling it, looking it up on YouTube, there probably are videos. But in those arcades, there are Japanese people which are playing rhythm games which I have never seen in my life before. And these arcade machines have, you know, they're just really incredibly set up. But some in really unique ways, which to me didn't really make sense. Like, if you're playing Guitar Hero, use a little fake looking guitar. That makes sense. There are some of these rhythm games in Japan arcades which are like you're turning dials and you're pushing these buttons and you're doing this, and it looks to my eyes pretty random. These people know what they're doing. They're fucking incredible at it. It's a spectacle. There's guys breaking fucking sweats, girls as well, hitting these buttons, doing all these different things. I mean, to those people, a game like this must be a godsend. People to play it in the comfort of their own home. It's going to offer them enough challenge. But I digress. Let's get back on to what's on the screen right now. This is another track I've put on. As you can see, each track comes with a little different background movie. In this one, it's like this fantasy role-playing game where there's archers and men and lots of armor and dragons and stuff like that. Some of them can be quite interesting to watch. Some of them play out like little animes, little cartoons, just different stuff going on in the background. I did like and appreciate that, although it might be distracting for some people. But again, when you play it enough times, it just starts to become another background and you start to take no notice of it, which is a bit of a shame because some of the little videos are quite nice. I probably should have pointed out before this point about when you're selecting a song, hi, there's like a 1-star rating, 2, 3, 4, and that's like a difficulty spike. The first video, or the first song in this video, which had the like cartoon playing in the background, that was a one star. That was as easy as we could find. Set at the slowest speed with the minimal amount of button inputs required. As you can see on the screen right now, down at the very bottom of like the would-be like phone, if you want to call it that, we'll have speed set at 1. At the left hand side of the screen, you'll see the little red bar. It's sort of midway. That's like your amount of mistakes you can make. Once that bar drains all the way down, it's game over. And there is the 4 buttons. The left, up, triangle, circle. That can be opened up to incorporate 8 button inputs. The speed, I forget what it goes up to. It also might be somewhere like 8. It's 5, 8, something like that. We'll see that, as I say, later on. This is a more difficult track. Starts off not so bad, but it ramps up. And then, a bit like being tongue-tied, you do get thumb-tied. Thumb-tied is definitely a thing. I can't remember at what point it goes pretty bad. There's some max 100% that looks not so bad. You know, you were doing okay here. This is one of the more difficult tracks. And then it all goes wrong. Well, we're building up. Oh, we made a mistake. Oh no, it's gone to shit now. Look at that bar. It's draining, draining. And it's game over. And it can be over as simple as that. If this game, a bit like the other rhythm games, if it has some sort of story mode, I don't know. If it does, I don't believe I could finish it. We're with DJ Hero and Guitar Hero, you know, on normal settings anyway. And again, this is the easiest settings that this game has. But with those other games, you try it, you can usually do the career mode. I mean, look at that. That was opened up to be in the 8 button configuration. At this point, I'm going to put speed up. So there we go, the speed goes up to times 5. And there is increments. It doesn't just go speed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's, you know, incremental, 1.25, all this sort of stuff. Here's at max speed. Trying to use the 8 buttons. Left, up, right, square, triangle, circle, L1, R1. I mean, what the hell. Now, to be fair, I didn't stick with that. I didn't try that 100 times to gradually get better and better. Know your limits. There are some things that I feel that I could get better at, and I will certainly put the time and effort in. I'm recording and showing this. That was my first attempt at that. Actually, that may have been. This is now the easiest track in the game, which earlier on in the video, at the very beginning, I'm able to complete this track. You go back to it. Put that difficulty up. You incorporate using more buttons. Barely lost it any amount of time. I know that went very quick. I should have lingered on that image a bit longer. But that thing that we're about to see now, that's Starways 7 or 8 star. And I forget how many stars it goes up to in terms of difficulty. But there can be quite a lot. And again, even that is sort of sitting midway. I think that was 8. This one's 4. Back up to 8 again. And it looks as if it's midway on that little star chart. You know, we've just went from yellow. We've entered into like an amber zone. Even still sticking with the 8 button combination layout. I thought, right, we'll lower the speed. I'll give this another try. It's still hell. I do feel that Max Respect differs from other rhythm games in that if you have a Guitar Hero on easy or normal difficulty, you could play each track and pass it probably first time round, realistically. Sure, you'll go back to those tracks to try and always better your score and try and get like a perfect run, but with DJ Max Respect, just moving from easier tracks and gradually building through their track listing. I already know that I'm going to be receiving the game over screen multiple times. I'm going to have to put a lot of time and effort into memories, to replay numerous times these tricks just to clear it once, let alone try and get incredible combos and perfect runs. DJ Max Respect is going to have a narrow window of who it appeals to. It's going to be people that like rhythm games, yes, but it's going to be those upper echelon style of players. It's going to be people who are extremely good at these games. That's just my belief. Yes, we're going to have, obviously we're going to have people, a bit like myself, I would still play it at a budget price, like I say. But you're going to have people that pick it up, enjoy it, have a few favourite tracks, or crap at a majority of them, and they still enjoy the game and are happy to promote it. But I do think the people which will get most enjoyment out of this title would be those people who play typical rhythm games on their hardest difficulty settings. These guys that have YouTube videos up where they're blasting out a really quick track, getting 100% accuracy, and are just amazing at them. This is a game for you. It offers something a little bit different. Songs that you more than likely are not going to know. And yeah, it's just a little bit of fresh air in a market which those game players are already well familiar with. I really don't think that this game is going to be for the average gamer. I just don't think that it brings to the table what other rhythm games do. Even if you're like an average casual gamer and you pick up a Rock Band or something, at least you can look on the back of the case and go, oh, I like 15 of those songs. Those are the songs you want to try and have a play at, try and get a good score at. You're not going to be familiar with the tracks in this game. The difficulty spike is quite substantial. So if you think you're just going to put it in every so often, have a go at a track, do pretty well at it, or be happy enough, you're probably going to get frustrated, as you'll probably get the end game screen a number of times unless you really stick with it. But as far as my first impression of DJ Max Respect goes, I was pleasantly surprised. I thought that it was interesting, just that you've got these different little animations in the background. I like that the tracks, although I don't know any, it's not to say that you can't enjoy something you've never heard before. It's just not your typical pop and rock songs which are in so many of these rhythm games. I enjoyed that it was more difficult than the rest, even though at times it was frustrating. If there's anyone out there who has also played this game, feel free to let me know what your thoughts and opinions on the game were. These first impressions of mine aren't really to suggest who should pick out the game. It's not a review or anything like that. It's just my opinion on what I've experienced with my little bit of gameplay. So hopefully you've enjoyed it, and you'll come back for another first impression or one of my other videos.